not just the equal sign, but the whole thing, the equation. Where is the equal sign on this scale?
Middle.
Middle.
Little
right?
Arrow.
Little arrow points down means equals. It points to the left means, well, not equal, right? Means the right side is greater, left side's greater, okay? And can anybody sum up why I went to the trouble of using a scale to teach you again, because I know you know about equations already, but to teach you again about equations, why did I pull out this scale and bother with all that? What was the importance of it? Monday morning, Josie.
Like to show the equations have to be equal, like why we have to do one thing on one side, we have to do it to the other side.
Good, very good. Yeah. If we do one thing to one side, not just that we have to do the same thing to the other side, but why we have to do the same thing to the other side. Okay? I hope that you know that if I had like a catchphrase, it would be why. Why do we do that? Alright? So how does this scale explain why we do the same thing to both sides of an equation? So if I were to set this guy here and a few of these little tokens on this side, and a little bunch of tokens over here. Okay, both sides are equal, right? We want to figure out what's in that container, or at least how much that container weighs. How do we go about doing that? A world of algebra, Sean?
Take away equal amount from both sides.
Because if we don't?
Because if we don't take away the equal amount, then one side's not going to, one side's going to be greater than the other.
Right, and then we're all messed up, right? If I take one off of, it makes more sense to take one off of this side because we're trying to get x by itself, and now it's all off.
Yeah.
Now I'll never know what x is. Okay? But if I take off the same amount on both sides, it stays balanced. An equation is balanced, it needs to stay balanced. Okay? That's the point. Okay, let's run through, well, let's get a few examples of any equations that you wrote over the weekend. Remember to write any equations, Josie?
2x equals 360.
2x equals 360, and what does that equation represent?
A rectangle cut in half.
Rectangle cut in half. Okay, so we've cut the rectangle in half and the number of angles multiplied by 2, right? If we add up all these angles here and multiply by 2, we should get 360, you're saying?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Any others?
X minus 180 equals 90.
X minus what?
180.
Equals 90. And what does that represent? Like what, where is that equation appropriate to use? You just threw it out there?
Yeah.
Okay, that is an equation, no denying that. Okay. Somebody asked me a question that they really, they could have used this equation that I threw out there at the end of class last time. Let's say we take x minus s equals d. I'm not sure what any of these amounts are, but if this represents, say if I hold my son in my hands and I get on the scale and that represents the weight that we have together, and I subtract, what do you think? Me, I get my son's weight, so that's Mr. Stewart, that's Declan. Okay. So if I take our combined weight, subtract my weight, we get his weight, because it's very hard to weigh a baby. They're very wiggly, and they don't want to stand on a scale, and they can't stand anyway. So I hold him, then I just stand there by myself, subtract the two, we get his weight. Okay? So that's an equation. Sean?
X divided by 2 equals R.
R, and what does that represent?
The diameter divided by 2 is the radius.
the diameter, so we could even make that d if we wanted.
Yeah.
Divided by 2 equals, well, r in this case is usually little r.
Yeah.
Little r. Diameter divided by 2 is radius. Okay, so we got some equations there. Good examples. Now, let's solve these equations. I don't want to just be told what x is. We're at the very beginning of creating good habits or bad habits. Hopefully not bad habits. Okay? So, someone, not just tell me what x is, but explain to me how to figure out what x is. Somebody new, I've already called them three. Alex?
You could take 73 minus 9, and whatever that is equals x.
Well, we're close. We are going to want to take 73 minus 9, but I also need to do what?
You need to do it on the other side.
Yeah, I'm sure you meant that.
Yeah.
But have to pick on you a little bit. So 64, right? 64. X minus 8 equals negative 2. What are we going to do there? Somebody new still? Charlie?
Add 8 on both sides.
Add 8. Okay, why are we adding 8 on this side?
Because you need to do it on both.
Because what?
You need to do it on both to make it equal.
Okay, well, so the idea for adding 8 came from what we see on this side, right? And so why would we add 8 to what we see here?
Because you're subtracting it.
Because it's subtracting 8. If we add 8, we get? 0, we get x plus 0, and negative 2 plus 8 is 6, so x must be 6. I want you to think about that. If you think about what we really want to get is like x plus 0, or maybe in another situation we're going to get 1 times x, or we're going to get x divided by 1, or x minus 0, that's the same as plus 0 pretty much. We want to manipulate the one side of the equation so that whatever's happening to x doesn't change the value of x. It just leaves x alone. If you multiply by 1 and you add 0, well, you still have x. Okay? It's especially useful there on number 4, if we can think that way. Okay. 3x equals 21. This is where we start to use that mentality. Rather than saying, oh, I can see what x would have to be, right? That's great. I mean, it's really important that you understand that x is a number, it's being multiplied by 3, and the result is 21. Or that these two multiplied together are equal to 21. But if you just say, oh, I can see what x is, you've already made it hard on yourself later on. Okay? So how do we solve that, Grady?
You divide by 3 on both sides.
Good, because 3 divided by 3 is a 1, so we have 1x. 7, and 1 times x is just x, so x must be 7. Okay? Now, here's a tricky one. Maybe it's not tricky. Maybe you guys are already great at this. Somebody new, if they can. Anybody besides Josie, Sean, Brady, Alex, Charlie. John, go ahead.
2/3 divided by 2/3.
Interesting. Okay.
X.
So divide the side by 2/3.
Yeah, and divide 16 by 2/3. But
okay. So first. 2/3 divided by 2/3. It looks messy, but it's a number. You divide by itself, which is always
one.
One. Run out of ink. 1x. Okay, now, Sean, how do we divide 16 by 2/3?
You have to go 16 over 1.
16 over 1.
Divided by 2/3.
Okay, divided by 2/3. Let's pretend
that. And then multiply, or then you'd have to use the reciprocal and do 16 over 1 times 3 over 2.
Right. Remember that we talked about dividing by fractions? We multiply by the reciprocal of the fraction we're dividing by.
And
all right.
That's 48 over 2.
Yes, it is.
And then that can be simplified to 24 over 1.
All right.
And then
24. Yep. Good. I skipped a few steps, but I like Sean's details there. Anybody else get 24? Okay. You should have noticed what Sean did there. He did not say, I don't know, I'll throw a number in there for X. I know that I'm just gonna divide by 3 and multiply by 2, and I'll just keep whittling away at it until I finally wind up with an x that gives me 16. Okay? If you're doing that, it's not bad, but it is going to make the future of algebra very difficult. Okay? So I want you to think in terms of how do I get x by itself, not how do I guess really well at what x must be. Okay? So that kind of, it's just, was to remind me to tell you about that, okay? If I see x plus 9 equals 73, and I say, well, there's some number, it must be 64, add 9. Oh, 64 it must be, because if I add 9 to 64, I get 73. That's right, and that's not a very hard equation to solve, okay? But this equation is a little harder to solve. Can anybody guess what x is? X would have to be, Sean?
I'm gonna go with, I don't know. No, I was gonna go with negative 3, but I don't, because the positive 3. I was thinking if I put 0 in, it'd just be plus 3, so
uh-huh.
Maybe negative 3.
Zeros out, there you're trying them out. I made this one pretty simple. Okay. Maybe at first you notice it needs to be negative because here's a 3, which is just 3, right?
Yeah.
If I'm going to get to 0, I need to subtract some numbers. So these need to be negatives. It's a good observation. Okay, so then we start thinking about negative numbers. All right, so this would all have to add up to negative all this stuff.
Yeah, negative.
It would have to be negative 3.
Yeah.
So then when you add 3, you get 0. So that's good. I mean, that's very, very good to start. But to solve any equation that looks like this, we have to have some better strategies than guessing, okay? And even if it didn't have a little square on there, and there weren't an x here and an x here that both have to be the same thing. Sometimes people forget this x have to be the exact same thing. So it starts to get complicated pretty quick. Even if it weren't like that, I could give you a complicated equation where there's just one x in there, and let's think in terms of every equation is a scale. We have to do the same thing to both sides, because if we don't, we throw both the sides off. Okay. So yeah, just a warning, word to the wise, heed this warning. Don't just guess what x is, even if you're a super duper good guesser. Learn to manipulate both sides of the equation in the same way. Let's look at that last equation again. 2/3 x equals 16. Remember, I want to wind up with not 2/3 times x, but 1 times x. Okay? I think it's pretty clear to see that we don't really care about getting x plus 0. There is no plus or minus anything. We want to get just a 1 times x. Pretty much anything I can do here goes, as long as we can get a 1x. Okay. So we can do exactly what Sean did, and get exactly the right answer. Or if I say to myself, it's kind of like it's doing what Sean did, exactly the same thing, but just kind of jumping ahead and saying, what if I just multiply 2/3 by 3/2? What happens when I multiply 2/3 by 3/2?
6.
6/6, then that's 1. 1x. Right. So I have to multiply this side by 3/2 as well. So we can multiply this out and get 48 over 2, get 24. If you remember your cross-canceling and you're multiplying fractions, 16 and 2 both have a factor of 2. 8 times 3 is 24. Over 1 times 1 is 1, so 24. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give you some equations, like several equations, and see how you do with each one of them. All right? And then walk around and see how everything's going. X. Okay, I'm gonna jump through these first two because it looks like we're on the same page here. If I add 5, well, first of all, if I add 5 to negative 5, you get 0. So I get x plus 0 over here. That's great. I'll have x and nothing else. Okay. The things I've made this side of the scale 5 heavier, right? So it's all out of balance. To keep it in balance, I add 5 to this side as well. And when I do that, I find that x plus nothing else is 17. So x must be 17. 1/5 times x is 2, so if we multiply this by 5, 5 over 5 is 1 times x. If 1 times x is 10, then x must be 10, because there's no other number that you multiply by 1 and get 10, so x must be 10. Okay. How about here, are we going to get x by itself?
3/4.
Multiply 4/3 on both sides, so we get 12 over 12, or 4 divides 4, and 3 divides 3, we get 1 over 1, either way, 1 times x. So you multiply this by 4/3 as well. Okay. And how did you handle that, Grady?
Well, you could just do 3/3 divided by 3, 3 divided by 3.
Right, so divide this by 3, divide by this, this by 3, we get 1, we get 11, 11 times 4. Okay, so now we have this, what's referred to commonly as a two-step equation. There are two things involved here, okay? And you may see a plus 6 and think, I'm going to subtract 6, okay? So that's like in my brain. Also, there's a 5x, and so there's a dividing by 5, right? So both of those things are part of this equation. Okay? Should I can I just divide by 5? Divide both sides by 5?
No.
I'm going to ask that question a lot. Can you, whatever, whatever, whatever. And a lot of times the answer is, yes, you can. Can you divide both sides by 5? If I divide both sides by 5, will both sides be balanced still?
Yes.
Yes. But dividing by 5 on both sides is not as easy as just saying 5 divided by 5 is x and leaving this plus 6. Okay? Let me show you. Let me use a picture that we have used, the scale. And I'll come up easily. This right here. Try that again. Okay. So if I have 5 X's, okay, so 5 mystery containers. Now, if I divide that by 5, what I'm saying is essentially, what's one of those worth, right? Look at 1/5 of that group is just 1. But I have this plus 6. Okay. On this side, I have
41.
That's going to be, let's do like a stack of 10. Okay, another stack of 10. Let's pretend these are 10s. And one more, 41. Okay? Divide this side by 5, I want to look at 1/5 of this side. I don't have to take 1/5 of everything. I have to take 1/5 of this group here, which would be easy enough because that'd just be one canister, that I, you know, a mystery canister. But I'd also have to look at 1/5 of this, and taking 6 and dividing it by 5 is kind of a hassle, right?
Yeah.
So, can you divide by 5 on both sides?
Yeah.
Yes, you can do it, but it may be a hassle, okay? So you may want to not do that right away. Okay. And also, especially, don't make the mistake of thinking that dividing by 5 just means 5 divided by 5 is 1 and leaving the 6 by itself, because you haven't divided the side by 5 if you don't divide everything by 5. All right. So maybe we don't do that first. Maybe instead we do something else first. Ideas on something else we could do first? Yeah, Blake.
Take away 6 from each side.
Take 6 away first. Let's look at that scale again. What if I take the 6 off of this side? Okay, what are you doing? Tapping. So if I take these six away first, look at that, I got 5x. You have like just five things. I could easily divide it by five in just a second. Okay. Come over here, we'll take six away from this side as well. We're gonna have to dip into this 10 here. So we'll take that one off, right? And then we got these guys here. If I want to take six, I'll have to take six from this group, which will leave four there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I want to take five actually there. So I've take one and then five more, that should leave five. Okay. Now dividing this side by five, much easier, right? And now dividing this side by 5, also a lot easier because it's 35, a number that's divisible by 5. Before it was 41, and that was a hassle as well. So we subtract 6, we get 5x equals 35. Now we can divide by 5, x equals 7. Okay, how confident do you feel about something like that? Or should we thumbs up? Give me a thumbs up, thumbs down. On that, thumbs up. Okay. If this, or really in the future, if anything looks intimidating to you, don't just look at it and think, man, that looks tricky. Just do something that you know is correct and see where that takes you. Okay? If you're not sure what that next step is going to look like, it's not important that you know what that next step looks like. You just do it, see what the next step turns out to be, and see what you might be able to do with that step. Do something that's correct, simplify some more, do something that's correct. You'll find just doing that, you can make your way through a lot of problems you didn't think you could do. Didn't get a chance to look at everybody's, but saw a lot of great work out there. All right. What is a thing that we could do that we're sure is correct? It's not all the way done, but it's something. Josie?
Distribute the 2 to the parentheses.
We've seen this before, right? 2 times a parentheses, can we distribute?
Yes.
Yes, we can, so why not? Distribute 2 minus 10x plus 4 equals negative 8. This is not what everybody did, and it does not mean that you are incorrect. It's just something that we're trying. Alex?
You could distribute the 4, you could do minus 4.
I don't think distribute is quite the right word we're going to use. Right? There's nothing to distribute, there's no parentheses here.
You could take minus 4 on each side.
We'll just subtract 4 from both sides, right? We just have 2 minus 10x plus 4, right? If I take that 4 away, it's just going to be hanging out there. Take it away. Take it away from both sides. 2 minus 10x equals negative 12 now.
Let's play something positive to take minus 2.
Subtract 2. Because this would be the same thing as to say negative 10x plus 2, right? It's the same. This side is 2 more than a negative 10x would be worth. So I'll take 2 away. Negative 10x equals negative 14. Nearly there, Sean.
Divide negative 10 from both sides.
Good, so negative 10 divided by negative 10 is, as weird as that might look, it's negative 10 divided by itself, which is 1. So we have x by itself, where a 1 times x. And negative 14 divided by negative 10, for one thing, is going to be a, what kind of a number?
Positive.
Positive, and it's going to be a decimal. What decimal is it?
1.4.
1.4. let's look quickly at something that others did. I think it's cool, creative. Before distributing, they just took that 4 off. Why not? It's the same as what we're looking at over there. Negative 12. And then, if you think about it, if you treat this parenthesis like a quantity that you don't know, like x, right? If this were 2x equals negative 12, what would you do right now? Divide by 2. No reason why we can't do exactly that right now. We can divide both sides by 2. 1 minus 5x, 1 times 1 minus 5x, which now we don't need any parentheses because it's times 1, equals negative 6. Subtract 1, negative 5x equals negative 7. Yeah, that's right. And divide by negative 5. And still, x is going to be 1.4. Of course. Okay, so instead of just distributing the 2 and then dividing by 2 later, why don't we just divide by the 2? There's like never even worry about the multiplying by 2. Both ways, completely fantastic. Doing either way makes sense to you. Okay? This way, maybe like one step faster, but it's not right. This isn't wrong. They're both great. They both found 1.4, and they both did it using algebra, not guessing. No guessing. Stop guessing. Guess and check. The day for that is gone. Put it away. We might use guess and check at the beginning of a new kind of an equation, but just for a minute. And then we move on to algebra, which is like a strategy for finding x. Other than guessing. Okay? So, we're actually going to do some homework out of the book. Not right now, I mean. Today's homework is going to be out of the book. We've caught up to the book. And later, we have built some skills that we will allow us to kind of zoom ahead later on in the book as well. So, in 1.1, I don't need to give you those. I'm going to give you 14. Let's get out of here. Have a good day.